Thank you. These names are so familiar to me, Vox said. This world yearns for a warrior of light. And blanks are to fulfill a prophecy to become Palamecia's hero. A blank would become the first warrior of light. However, an ancient Moogle was leading me to the home of the supposed elder warrior of light.
This way.
Elder warrior of light.
You may already be aware, but this world once boasted someone with the title of the Warrior of Light.
Wait, what exactly do you mean by that? The prophecy said there hasn't been one yet, that one is going to appear.
It will all be clear soon. You will meet with a man who became a hero, and became the very source of that prophecy. He was the first Warrior of Light, and the name he bore was the same as your own.
So he's my predecessor.
Not in the way that you mean it. Let me instead call him Palamecia's point of origin.
You mean a god?
No. It appears I have completely confused you.
It's Vox?
Vox plays a role necessary for Palamecia's survival.
Meaning what?
Is that question rhetorical?
I suppose it is, at that.
Thank you.
inside that counts.
Farewell!
Everything out for myself. It'll be all right. You can trust me.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I have guided an aspirant like yourself.
Who else was there?
Other blanks, as eager as you are.
I mean, what did they look like?
Perhaps this comes as a surprise to you, but Moogles are wholly unable to distinguish one human being's face from another's. Still, each one of you gives off a different light, and that's how we can tell which one of you is whom.
So Mog and Moog too?
Yes. The same is true for all Moogles, without exception.
That's a bit odd. I thought that all Moogles shared a consciousness.
Not all desire to do so. That's why I chose to sever my pom-pom from the collective. The pom-pom is merely a symbol, to be sure. And our real communication takes place within our hearts. So perhaps I'm not a Moogle, because I lack a Moogle's heart.
Thank you.
Just you wait.
Master desires to see if you are, in fact, worthy.
He's the one who called me here, and now he's giving me a test.
Show him the power of the Warrior of Light. You will lose nothing in doing so.
Is that encouragement?
Thank you. one notch for every time I hit you.
You
Dolores is quieter than I expected.
She's not comfortable around strangers.
A most enlightened decision, indeed.
Wait, how do you know she's being quiet? Moogles can't sense fairies, right?
Have you forgotten what I said? I may look like a Moogle, but I am not one anymore.
So you operate outside of Palamecia's laws.
Thank you.
displayed great drive in vanquishing the guardians protecting this sacred place.
If a shadow can serve as a guardian, does that mean your master can take command of them?
No being can control their actions. They gave themselves in to the rage they felt in combat, and their souls are obsessed with the desire to kill. All they need is a battlefield, and they will fight until they eventually succumb.
So, your master uses the replaceable husks as guardians?
As I said, all they can do is fight. You have saved them from despair by vanquishing them and gifting them with respite.
is always the same.
Another fight against shadows. You said they gave in, but what are they?
They are just that. No more, no less.
Are they spirits?
Not quite. They walk between life and death.
That's not an answer.